The greatest concentration of American naval power in a decade is an accident of scheduling and navigation, according to the U.S. Navy. But the coincidental convergence of three nuclear-powered aircraft carriers and their warplanes and escort ships on the Pacific Ocean in early November lends military heft to President Donald Trump's escalating war of words with North Korea. The carriers USS Ronald Reagan, USS Nimitz, and USS Theodore Roosevelt, plus their nearly 200 warplanes and roughly 20 escorting cruisers, destroyers, and submarines, are due to converge in the Western Pacific on November 11 for a three-day war game. The last time three American flat tops met was in 2007. It is a rare opportunity to train with two aircraft carriers together, and even rarer to be able to train with three, said ADM Scott Swift, commander of the U.S. Pacific Fleet. The Navy has 278 frontline ships. As of November 6, 104 of them were deployed, 67 of them in the Pacific. The three-way war game coincides with Trump's marathon tour of Asia, during which he continued his rhetorical attack on North Korea and its nuclear program. "Do not underestimate us and do not try us," Trump warned Pyongyang during a November 7 speech in South Korea. The massive fleet steadily assembling in the adjacent ocean underscored Trump's words. Even if, according to the Navy and experts, the flat-off meeting was mere coincidence. "This exercise is not about current events or other countries," Commander Clay Doss, a spokesperson for the Navy's Pacific-based 7th Fleet, told the Daily Beast. "It's just another example of the Navy's regular and routine presence in the Western Pacific. All three aircraft carriers are conducting routine deployments in multiple areas of operation that happen to converge in the Western Pacific," Doss added. "This overlap is an opportunity to show a unique capability, one that no other Navy has, to operate multiple carrier strike groups close to each other." Right double quotation mark. The Navy knew as early as 2014 that three carriers deployments might overlap in the Pacific, according to Dr. Jerry Hendricks, a retired Navy officer and analyst at the Center for a New American Security in Washington, D.C. "We have seen this opportunity for a three-carrier exercise coming for 3 years given the fleet deployment schedule," Hendricks told the Daily Beast. Nimitz is returning home to the U.S. West Coast from launching airstrikes on behalf of U.S. Central Command, or CENTCOM, in the Middle East. Roosevelt is sailing west to replace Nimitz. Reagan's home port is in Japan. Every 3 years or so, one West Coast carrier will relieve another West Coast carrier with the CENTCOM mission, Hendricks explained. "That is what is happening here. Right double quotation mark. But there's risk in surging the fleet before it's at full health." In September. The greatest concentration of American naval power in a decade is an accident of scheduling and navigation, according to the U.S. Navy. But the coincidental convergence of three nuclear-powered aircraft carriers and their warplanes and escort ships on the Pacific Ocean in early November lends military heft to President Donald Trump's escalating war of words with North Korea. The carriers USS Ronald Reagan, USS Nimitz, and USS Theodore Roosevelt, plus their nearly 200 warplanes and roughly 20 escorting cruisers, destroyers, and submarines, are due to converge in the Western Pacific on November 11 for a three-day war game. The last time three American flat tops met was in 2007. It is a rare opportunity to train with two aircraft carriers together, and even rarer to be able to train with three, said ADM Scott Swift, commander of the U.S. Pacific Fleet. The Navy has 278 frontline ships. As of November 6, 104 of them were deployed, 67 of them in the Pacific. The three-way war game coincides with Trump's marathon tour of Asia, during which he continued his rhetorical attack on North Korea and its nuclear program. "Do not underestimate us and do not try us," Trump warned Pyongyang during a November 7 speech in South Korea. The massive fleet steadily assembling in the adjacent ocean underscored Trump's words. Even if, according to the Navy and experts, the flat-off meeting was mere coincidence. "This exercise